I can't seem to find my toothbrush, so I'll pick one up when I go out today. Other than that, I'm in good shape.
When we talk about storytelling through kids and films, we all know Home Alone is the first movie that pops up in our mind. Or maybe Charlie and the Chocolate Factory.
Let's be friends. Best friends.
Everyone enjoys a good kids film, all lovey-dovey and full of humor and family-friendly content. In short, a movie Disney would like to market. But there are so many films out there that have kids as protagonists, which actually talk about important topics. It's not only adults that have complex emotions, trauma, and mental battles. Kids have them too. These films basically try to capture a whole new way to look at the world through a child's eye. So today I'm going to talk about 7 brilliant films with kids as protagonists. And no, I'm not going to be talking about Netflix movies where Noah Centineo plays the role of a 16-year-old kid.
Whoa, hold on, stop.
First I wanna talk about is the film Wonder. It is one of my favorite films out there. This is about the kid Augie who was born with facial differences and was never able to attend a normal school up until he starts his 5th grade. It is about the kid who faces bullying and fails to make friends because of the way he looks.
Ah! Holy crap! Look at his face!
It is also about the parents who have to keep themselves strong mentally and emotionally along with their kid to be accepted by the normal world. This film was overall an emotional journey for me through different stories each character has in this film. I'm not the type of person who usually cries during a film, but boy oh boy, this film doesn't let you hold back. Second, I want to talk about is Boyhood. It is a beautiful film directed by Richard Linklater over the span of 12 years. Yes, you heard me right. This film took 12 years to make because it follows the journey of a kid Mason through his teenage years after his parents get divorced, due to which him and his sister has to move home to home, city to city with their mom and her ever-changing multiple husbands. This film captures the growth of a shy young kid and his relationship with his various stepdads and his visiting biological dad who is played by Ethan Hawke. This film definitely brings a breath of fresh air in the world of cinema because of the way it was written and edited. In 2015, Boyhood got nominated in 6 categories at the Oscars for Best Picture, Director, Screenplay, Editing, including the nominations for Best Supporting Role, Male and Female, for Ethan Hawke and Patricia Arquette.
Patricia Arquette, Boyhood.
I mean, being nominated at the Academies among these films shows that how much of a great film this was. Next, I want to talk about is 8th Grade, a film which is directed by a famous ex-YouTuber, Bo Burnham. I actually related to this movie a lot compared to other movies I talk about in this video. Being a YouTuber himself, he knew how he would be able to relate to the younger generation of today. This film shows the life of a shy and insecure middle schooler who is very introverted in public, but expresses her thoughts and feelings in her videos on YouTube. Just like every other kid these days, she looks up to people on the internet to gain self-confidence. Her videos are very private, or she does not like talking about them among her peers because, like every introverted person, including me, she doesn't want to be the laughingstock at the school. I think Bo Burnham did a really great job to capture the thoughts and aspirations of being a middle schooler, where you try to be included among cool kids and start rebelling against your parents. Next film is The Florida Project. This film is set in Florida at the most magical place in the world. Well, not really. It takes place in the outskirts of the Disneyland. It's a drama film shot in a very documented type manner to show how a 6-year-old girl, Moni, lives at the motel with her young, emotionally unstable mother who struggles to meet their daily needs. This film captures the innocence in children and how they are still carefree and happy among themselves because they don't know the real hardships of an adult yet. What brings out the realism in this film is that the only professional actor in this film is Willem Dafoe. Other than him, it is the first time acting for every person in this film, which gives a very natural look to it. And let me be honest, this is the most wholesome character Willem Dafoe has ever played. So if you're a Dafoe fan, the fuck are you waiting for? The cinematography and color palette of this film is one of the best I've seen lately. Talking about color palette and cinematography, my next film is by my favorite director, Wes Anderson. We all know how much Wes Anderson likes to tell complex stories through kids in his films, be it The Royal Tenenbaums, Rushmore, or Fantastic Mr. Fox.
Excuse me everyone, I'm gonna go meditate for half an hour.
But for this video, I chose Moonrise Kingdom.
What kind of bird are you?
I'm a sparrow, she's a dove.
No, I said. What kind of bird are you?
This film is a love story of two 12-year-old kids, an orphan boy Sam and a girl Susie, who lives with their emotionally abusive parents. How they decided to run away from their places to get married and form their own paradise. This film captures the idea 12-year-old kid has of an ideal world. I love this film because of how it takes place before the time technology took over, giving it an old school love story vibe, with very subtle and quirky humor added with beautiful cinematography, costumes and locations. Talking about location, I just don't want this channel to be aimed towards Hollywood films. I want to talk about good films. So that gives me a way to introduce you guys to good Bollywood and other foreign films as well. So for the next film, I want to talk about Tare Zameen Par. And I just discovered that it released with the name of Like Stars on Earth in other countries. This film shows the life of a kid Ishan who is not good with academics, due to which his parents end up sending him to a boarding school where he meets his teacher, who later discovers that Ishan suffers from dyslexia, who later helps Ishan find his potential in art. I love this film since my childhood because it focuses on the individual personalities and strength of every kid rather than expecting them to fit in the education system of the society. If you are from India, then you have most certainly seen this film. But if you are from any other country who is hearing about this film for the first time, then I would really, really recommend you to go watch this film today, then thank me later in the comments. Before I jump to my last film, I would like to give 3 honorable mentions because these films are as great as other films I have talked about in this video. Last film I want to talk about is possibly the most underrated film out there, Mid-90s. This film is Jonah Hill's directorial debut and let me tell you, it's freaking amazing. This film takes place in the 90s, well obviously, where a kid Stevie who is domestically abused by his older brother tried to find a getaway outside his home. That's when he finds a group of these cool skater kids and get highly influenced by them, which makes him want to be a part of them and their culture. All the characters in this film are non-actors, which gives it more of a real heart-to-heart connection to skate and hip-hop culture, because they are just acting in their natural day-to-day environment, which ironically doesn't look like they are acting at all. You know what I mean here? What I mean to say is that their acting is so good that just never mind. Just please go watch this film, because it is a must-watch for every hip-hop lover, skater, and most certainly a film lover. Man, I'm just hoping that this film gets the attention it deserves. That's it for today guys, I know you guys have a lot of time to watch films this year, so please add these films in your watch list because you will not regret watching any of these films. And if you are new here, hit the subscribe button. And oh, some of you actually liked and commented on a Friends vs The Office video for the algorithm and ended up watching till the end, which bought me more watch time and eventually more viewers, so thank you so much for that. Please do it here as well, I will see you in the next one.
Thank you guys for watching this video. I hope some of you guys found it helpful. And make sure to subscribe to my channel. And yeah, thank you for watching. Gucci!